This video lesson will illustrate the process of defining trade areas and producing trade area reports around a site whose attractiveness for a retail location we would like to evaluate. What you see is a satellite image of a CBSA in the middle of the United States, and we're going to look at a particular location in that area and evaluate it for a fitness club that we're going to call ABC Fitness for purposes of our exercise. Let's start by looking at some of the layers that you created in the earlier video lesson when you were doing environmental scanning and opportunity analysis. This is a thematic map, a color-coded map, which shows expenditures on recreational and social clubs on an annual basis per household in this region of the country. The darker green are areas where there are higher concentrations of expenditures. There are also, within this area, several competing health clubs, and you can see them here displayed based on the size and sales of the particular club. ABC Fitness has an option on a particular location in this area and wants to evaluate the trade area characteristics around that site. Let's zoom in on that a little bit and see the type of location that they're looking at in terms of the retail environment. And notice here that we've selected a site within an existing building at a fairly major intersection within this geographic area. So let's move back to that level of zoom, reinstall the thematic layer, and now what we're going to do is create a market area around that site. We don't need customer data. It's going to be simple rings around ABC Fitness, 10 and 20 miles in a donut approach, which means that the population of the inner ring and the outer ring are going to be completely different. So the firm will be able to assess the characteristics of the group between 10 and 20 miles as they compare with a group between 0 and 10 miles from the site. We're going to order some reports for the site for individual features, and those reports are the executive summary and the retail expenditure report. Okay, we're going to see those all at once on the screen, and now we're ready to go. So we click finish. The system goes to work. And these are the 10 and 20 mile rings that constitute the trade areas that the organization is looking for. In addition to that, we have two reports that were generated. This was the executive summary. Let me zoom in on that one just a little bit. And so you can see that this first column is the population within the 0 to 10 mile range. The second one is the population within the 10 to 20 mile range of that particular location. So we can see how they compare. We have information on income, housing, number of households, information on current income, households by income level. We also have some data on the population by levels of education in that market area. The second report you produce is the retail goods and expenditures report, and that's done for the 10 and 20 mile rings around the store. In this case, we're looking at the 10 mile ring first of all. And the number we're looking at that's most relevant is this one on membership fees for clubs. And what we can see is that each household spent an average of $123 in 2009, or $3.6 million for the whole trade area. That $123.64 is about 72% of the national average. So on average, the households in the United States spent a little bit more on this category than did the households in this market area. Let's take a look at the 10 to 20 mile ring. Now this is the group of people who lives beyond 10 miles but within 20 miles of the club, and what we see is that number goes down both in terms of average expenditures and total expenditures. So that outer ring represents only $2.5 million of sales as opposed to 3.6 in the inner ring at only about 64%. So what this means in this particular case is that most of the best customer household are concentrated within about 0 to 10 miles of that location. So with these reports and others that you might use based on the particular store, retail environment that you're working with, you get some idea of the attractiveness of that site. You're now able to evaluate it in terms of its relationship to pockets of sales of the item or the relevant expenditure that you're looking for, its proximity to competing stores that might serve as a competitive factor in the market, and now you're able to make very specific projections of the characteristics of the trade area that you define around the store. So that's the way that you can use the tools of Business GIS as you're evaluating sites for a potential business in the process of developing a marketing plan for an entrepreneurial new business. And that concludes this video lesson.